called Pin Shuffle. And I learned this last week at the Tapered Conference in 2015 from Capel ISD. So here's how we play. I adapted it. I'm using kicking skills. You can use throwing or rolling as well. So in our activity, what we're going to do is you take your gym and you put bowling pins down the center, and each bowling pin belongs to one little game. So you have multiple games going on. We put three kids on each team, and they each have a gator skin ball. We put one dot in the center, so we're using floor tape, and then we put three more spaced out coming back towards one side, and three more dots coming back out towards the other side. Okay, and here's what they're going to do. On their team, we tell them you don't have to wait in line. When you're ready to kick, you can go ahead and kick. Okay, so they're going to kick the ball and try to knock down their bowling pin. So my team is going to get the team directly across from us. Okay, there's the red team on that other side. Okay, so when I kick it, I'm going to kick, and then I knocked it down, and I'm going to set the bowling pin back up on the next dot closer to my team. Then I can go get my ball and run back and do it again, okay? So now my teammates are kicking, they're kicking, I put it down, and I kick, and I miss, so I simply get my ball, okay? While we're trying to advance it to our side, the opposite team is trying to do the same. So if they knocked it down here, they would move it one dot closer back towards them. Okay? When the teams and get it to their very last dot, and they knock it down on the very last dot, the team would get a point, and they would set the bowling pin back up down the center. Okay? So that bowling pin is constantly shuffling back and forth. Our students are really enjoying this one, and I hope yours do as well. As always, thank you for subscribing, commenting, liking, and sharing the videos. I'm Coach Perola reminding you to keep on moving.